Friends, what's up and welcome to another session of English Literature. So today's session is all about stream of consciousness. So in this session, I will discuss what is stream of consciousness novel, why this technique is used in novels and the major novelists of stream of consciousness technique. Okay, so now let's start the session. So the term stream of consciousness comes from the psychology. It was coined by William James in 1890 and it was popularized in William James's Principles of Psychology in 1819, okay? So according to William James, every definite image in the mind is stopped and died in the free water that flows round it. Consciousness does not appear to itself chopped up in bits. It is nothing joined, it flows. Let us call it stream of thing, stream of consciousness or of subjective life. So friends, this quotation is quite important. So if you are writing anything on stream of consciousness, so then please put this quotation into a note, okay? So the concept of stream of consciousness has added a new and significant dimension to the art of prose fiction. Actually, this stream of consciousness genre of novel took birth between 1930 and 1915. So this was a kind of introduction of stream of consciousness novel. So now let's know a kind of detailed description of stream of consciousness novel. So the stream of consciousness is the name for a special mode of narration that undertakes to reproduce without a narrator's intervention the full spectrum and the continuous flow of a character's mental process, in which sense perceptions mingle with conscious and half-conscious thoughts, memories, expectations, feelings and random associations. The term interior monologue is reserved for that species of stream of consciousness, okay? So stream of consciousness novel is a modern development and reflects recent interest in the analytical school of Jung, means Carl Jung, Freud, means Sigmund Freud and Adler, and the free association used by psychiatry. So from this, it's clear that stream of consciousness technique is used by the novelists to bring out the mental or the inner feelings of a character. So the stream of consciousness in its radical form is sometimes described as the exact presentation of the process of consciousness, because sense perceptions, mental images, feelings and some aspects of thought, they are non-verbal. We cannot somehow explain it verbally. So it is clear that the author can present these elements only by converting them into some kind of verbal equivalent. So that's why James Joyce developed a variety of devices for stream of consciousness narrative in Ulysses. So in the stream of consciousness novel, everything is presented through an apparently unorganized succession of images and ideas connected by association rather than by logical argument or narrative sequence. The action takes place and the plot develops through the mind of the principal character, and his stream of consciousness reflects all the forces of which he is aware, as they are playing upon him at any one moment, both inside and outside, more or less simultaneously. So basically, the point of this paragraph is that a person's thoughts and his conscious reactions are the main drawn out theme in the stream of consciousness novels. Okay. So in the 19th century, stream of consciousness was very popularized. So there are some significant features of this new literary genre. It becomes a literary genre, okay? Okay, so in this point, I want to make one thing clear, that you can pronounce genre as genre also, okay? So you can also pronounce it as genre and as genre, okay? So number one significant feature is, in this kind of novel, means in stream of consciousness novel, plot and characters have decayed. Set descriptions of character of the older novel are substituted by the depiction of the inner selves. It means that in the older type of novels or older genres of novels, the characters are mostly described externally, or the novels are basically set by their external behavior. But in the stream of consciousness novel, the inner self of the character or the inner ideas, the conscious ideas, the awareness is brought out. And then the next significant feature of stream of consciousness novel is, in the place of plot construction, in the sense of a logical arrangement of incidents, in stream of consciousness novel, we notice a backward and a forward movement in time. Basically, stream of consciousness novel ends with a sudden realization. A character or the protagonist ended up by realizing his misdeed, by realizing his faults, as we see in the case of a portrait of the artist as a young man. Okay, so then the next feature is, instead of concentrating around a limited issue, the stream of consciousness novelists fly off in an eccentric manner in different direction. So here, eccentric manner means irrelevant manner. Okay, so the stream of consciousness novels are quite difficult to understand. So these are the features of stream of consciousness novels. So the first modern novelist who consciously employed the stream of consciousness was Dorothy Richardson. She came in the limelight by her novel Pointed Roof and Pilgrimage. Then James Joyce was another major novelist who used the stream of consciousness in A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man, Ulysses and Finnegan's Wake. Okay, so later Virginia Woolf, who is one of the influential female writers, she began as a traditional novelist and then she showed remarkable courage to break free from the tradition and wrote a few remarkable stream of consciousness novels. Her remarkable novels like Jacob's Room, Mrs. Dalloway, To the Lighthouse, The Waves, Between the Acts, these novels depict the psychological time and incoherent state of consciousness. Then after this, there comes D.H. Lawrence. So D.H. Lawrence, though he is not a stream of consciousness novelist, but he is very well conversant with psychoanalytical theories of Freud and Jung. And thus he depicted the unconsciousness of his mind through the impressionistic and symbolic techniques. So as the stream of consciousness technique is a bold experiment in modern fiction, so its potency and possibility are well demonstrated by great authorities like, or the great writers like James Joyce and Virginia Woolf. So in this way, the writers brings out the character's inner self or inner consciousness in their writing, especially in their novels. So that's it. So friends, I hope this video will definitely help you. And if it is, then please turn the black thumb blue, means like the video, share the video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you want to know about any topic of English literature, then please comment me so that I can make a video of it. So bye bye for now. See you in the next session very soon.